Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we'll take a look at three benefits of using an external display or a dual monitor setup when editing in Final Cut Pro. For my setup, I use a slightly older 2015 15-inch MacBook Pro connected to a BenQ PD2700U monitor. But the same thing can be accomplished by pretty much using any Mac connected to any decent display. The first benefit, especially if like me, you use a laptop, is screen size. The 27-inch display on my monitor is almost twice as big as my MacBook Pro. Opening Final Cut Pro on this display and setting it to full screen gives you a ton more room. This is what Final Cut Pro looks like on my MacBook. And this is Final Cut Pro on the 27-inch external display. As you can see, there's way more room for my timeline, and I can have the media browser and the inspector open all the time and still have a decent sized viewer window. You can even press Ctrl Command 4 to toggle inspector height to extend it all the way down to the bottom of your window. A lot of the time when editing on my laptop, I usually have to close my browser window and the inspector window when not using them, just to make my viewer window a reasonable size. Using a larger display allows me to keep all the windows open and still maintain a reasonably sized workspace. The second benefit of using an external display is you can use Final Cut Pro in a dual monitor setup. Whenever you have a second display connected to your Mac in Final Cut Pro, you'll see a second display content button. Clicking on this button will open up a drop-down menu and let you choose what part of Final Cut Pro will be displayed on the second screen. You can select to have your timeline on your second screen, your viewer, or the media browser. This depends largely on your screen setup, but for my combination, I prefer to have the media browser on my MacBook screen. This way, I have my timeline, a nice sized viewer window, and the inspector open on my main screen, with my media still readily available on the second screen. The third benefit of using an external display is Final Cut Pro has an AV output option that lets you send the audio and the video from your Mac to an external display. This allows you to see what your project looks like on a reference monitor, such as the factory calibrated BenQ monitor I'm using. Your Final Cut Pro window will look the same as if you were just using a single display, but your viewer will also be displayed on your reference monitor. Any screen controls, such as the transform tools, will only be visible in Final Cut Pro. To use your external display as a reference monitor, you either need a Mac with an HDMI port, or if your Mac doesn't have an HDMI port, you'll need a third-party video interface hardware and software. For this example, we'll use my 2015 MacBook Pro with an included HDMI port used to connect it to the external monitor. To set this up, first, open System Preferences on your Mac and select Displays. Set the HDMI monitor as a secondary display by making sure the white line is on top of your primary display. Hold down the Option key while clicking the Scale button and select your display's resolution. Close the System Preferences window, and if you have Final Cut Pro open, close and restart it. From the menu bar, select Final Cut Pro, Preferences, and click on the Playback tab. From the AV output menu, choose the HDMI monitor. Now, to output your viewer to your reference monitor, from the menu bar select Window and Output to AV. This will display what your exported video will look like on the HDMI screen. You'll see whatever's in your viewer, minus any on-screen controls. This is a very helpful feature, especially when color grading your clips, to help you see what the finished video will look like, and if using a properly calibrated monitor, you'll see exactly what the colors and the detail in your video looks like.
So, as you can see, using an external display with Final Cut Pro can be very helpful and beneficial, especially when using a high-quality reference monitor, such as the PD2700U from BenQ. This monitor was provided to me free of charge from the marketing team at BenQ, and I'm currently testing it. Once testing is complete, I will do a full, dedicated review video, but so far, it's been great. I'll leave a link for it in the video description below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button, and if you're new here, check out the rest of my channel for more Final Cut Pro tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.